So today is only the informal talk. ठीक है? Everyone is here. So first I will write some points on the board, and then you must have viewpoint about that, what you think. Are written in Upanishad, translated in Hindi, English. Mainly these are written in Sanskrit. You are what your deep driving desire is. What your desire is, you are. As your desire is, so is your will. Whatever be the desire, so is your will. As your will is, so is your deed. Whatever is your will, willpower, you can perform accordingly. And as your deed is, so is your destiny. Okay. These few lines explains that why you should get motivated in your life. You can make your environment such that you feel motivated, you get inspired. Take the negatives out of that. If the person is around you, he is negative, try to make him positive. And if he is not positive, then keep aloof from him. Be in some other company. So, some of your responsibilities of being a student, being a son, is that whatever you are taking from the parents, you have to give them back, because they are spending huge money on your education. Secondly, being as that citizen of the country, or being as belong to some society, you should have give it back to society in one means or another. Okay? So you should be such that you should think in these terms, technical knowledge is a different thing. Someone is technically sound or not, someone is not. But be a good human being. Sometimes when you are, suppose you get motivated by something and you are doing some work, but after day's work you are feeling quite frustrated. Like suppose that you are reading something and after that you feel that my friends, they are now working in some good company, they are earning money, and some of them are, they have married and they have sons and daughters also. So don't be carried away by these kind of attitude. Be focused so that you can achieve your destiny, whatever it may be. Try to excel. The main idea of the education is not only to give you the basic technical knowledge, but also to be a good human being. Being good humans, because you are the destiny of the country. Okay? So like Swami Vivekananda has said that if you fail, if you do some work, if you fail, you will guide others. If you succeed, then it's good. Similar to the teachers, if they have succeeded in B.Tech level, then they would have been some industry. Then some people have different level of motivation. No one is going to study more after B.Tech or M.Tech. But still, if the options are not available, we can do that. But some are doing for there are very less who are doing out of the passion. Very less people. So what we are doing, whatever the failures we face, so that's why we are now guides. We are guiding others to have. Okay. So the main idea is that you should get motivated in that aspect. Some of the basic things of motivation is that, some points are there. You can get motivated by these points and think yourself that how you can perform well in whatever way it would be. So I have certain points which you should keep in mind. First is you find the inspiration. Second, feel excited. Have the excitement in life. Third is set the goal. Fourth is post your goal. Fifth is make your plan perfectly. Sixth is take a break from the world. Seventh is remove the negativity and think positively. Eighth is do selfless work. And ninth is eat healthy and stay healthy. And tenth is share your knowledge. Now let us come to first point, find your inspiration. So whenever you are doing something, you should get inspired by something. So what inspires you? There are different levels of inspiration. What inspires you? Inspiration is, you can get inspiration from the internal self. And motivation, you can get motivated from outside, but some person, you can get motivated from some first person like that. Inspiration should come from inside, that how you get inspired, why you get inspired. So any this example of inspiration, if suppose you want to get the inspiration, any example of that. Thus, like social work, someone is doing the social work. He gets inspired by the social work, because whatever he is getting after the social work, it's mental peace and all that kind of thing. So that's the inspiration. You can get the inspiration from by reading the biographies of some of the great personalities. And you can read from the electrical point of view, you can read the Nikola Tesla. His life is very different as compared to Edison. Edison was only concerned about the money, but the Tesla was concerned about social rather than money. You can read the book by Steve, that is a life story of Jobs, Steve Jobs. So you can get inspired some way, so that you can have, you can motivate and inspire yourself, your internal self, so that you can do the things well. Sometimes you have the inspiration that you want to earn money. That is also one sort of inspiration. You want to earn money, you want to earn 2 or 3 lakhs per month, like that. That may be the sort of inspiration, but it's a materialistic kind of thing. ठीक है? Second क्या था? Feel excited. So whenever you should do the small work in your life, small work, like suppose your exams has finished, so you should have party. I think usually you used to do party after exams. Yes, sir. So feel excited about everything once you have accomplished something. Suppose you have completed the second semester. Second semester is over, so let's have some party. Then you should have after this examination also, and after small kind of thing, like you will see in players also when they hit the six in matches now, IPL is going on, so they will celebrate that kind of thing. So from the celebration they get more motivation. So be excited in that aspect also. It will excite, it will whatever the spark that you have because of the inspiration, it will ignite that spark, that is excitement. Otherwise your inspiration will gone. Once you are inspired something, then after a small achievement you should have some excitement. You should show the excitement that I have done this thing. So be excited, then your inspiration level will increase after that. ठीक है? Next is set a goal. Whenever you are doing something, suppose you are giving some exam, set the goal accordingly. Without that you cannot do the work. Without that you cannot, it's very difficult to be successful. You should set the goals that what is the goal of what, suppose I am doing some work, what is the goal of that? I am preparing for this examination. So what would be the goal of that? From that, by identifying that goals, what is, you can identify that where you are lagging. Suppose you are going for some interview. An interviewer asks some questions and very nicely you have given answers of maximum of the questions, but some questions you are unable to give the answer. You should note out, after coming to that, you should note out that questions, find out the answers of that. So it is according to the planning. If you are planning well, your goal is set that what to do or what not to do. Then like Ankur, he has a now goal that he is becoming the future teacher. So similar to the others also, Das. So they have the set goals, and others they have the goal to pass some examination, so that in future it's not they are not in that dependent PhD type of thing, because they don't want to waste their energy in that. So I am joking, just joke. ठीक है? Next is post your goal. Post your goal means that whatever your goal is, you should write it down. Wherever you are studying, suppose your studies table is there, you should paste there that this is my goal. I have to achieve at any any cost, I have to achieve it, I have to work hard. Once you are posted your goal, then you can automatically, the things will change, because you will see that I have not done anything for the goal that I must study. Then automatically the things will change for you, and you are automatically feel in that respect also. And it is a kind of force, you can say, it will take you to some convergence point in optimization kind of thing, that you should get your speed of going to the goal. So post your goal, but divide these goals in different kind of different steps. Like suppose that you are preparing for the examination also. So don't be like that put one book here, there, like that, because it will disturb you. Take one book, read it, check out the strategy that suppose I have to complete 5 chapters and after that I will start this. So see whether you have completed or not. Not completed, then you are lacking something, then you can do it for some other subject. So you should have this thing in mind so that you can be successful. Now next is to make your plan perfectly. It means that whenever you plan, make sure that it should be perfect. Suppose you are going for outside, suppose you want to go to Manali, then you plan accordingly. It's not that you take the bus and then go to Manali there. You plan it accordingly. That is, you first see that what places you have to see there, and then after that you will what travel agencies would be there and where to stay, like that. So your stay would be very peaceful if you are doing it that way. Otherwise you should have taken this bus and then searching there. It's very similar to your life also. You should make your plan such a way that it should be perfect. Try to make it perfect. Try to make it in such a way that you should have that thing in mind. Okay? Next is, take a break from the work. It's not always that you will study the things every time. You will study. So all work and no play makes maybe Jack or maybe someone a dull boy heard that. So don't study so much. Study smart and hard. Be smart, which points to consider, which not to consider, and don't be like that you are always studying and then you forget everything after some time. So be like smart person. Related to forgetting things, I will tell you, it has been proved scientifically that whatever you are studying, within 24 hours you have to revise it. Suppose you are studying something, the way in which it works is done scientifically. Suppose you are studying something, then suppose you read a chapter, then if you have not learned it or revised it within 24 hours, then you will retain only 10% in after 24 hours. It is scientifically done study. That is, suppose you are studying, you study that, revise it within 24 hours. And when you are revising, suppose you have spent 2 hours for that, when you are revising it, you have to spend only 15 minutes on that. Maybe 15 minutes or less than that. Thodi der mein. So whenever you are suppose you want to learn something, do revision of 24 hours. Then after 24 hours there is no need to do revision for some days, 7 days. It works like that. Suppose you are revising it after 24 hours, then you have to revise it after 7 days of that. And then when you have revised after 7 days, then you will revise it every month. It will be retained in your memory. That's how memory works. So whenever you are reading something, suppose you want to retain it for some moment, it happens that you read some chapter. Suppose you read 2 months back, and when you are very confident, okay, I know everything, I know this thing, I know this thing. But when you are sitting on the table, you will see that, oh, I have to work hard on that because every memory is lost. So memory works like that. Whenever you are reading something, give a revision after 24 hours, then give the second revision after 7 days, and then give the revision after 1 month, every 1 month, and it will decrease. Like suppose that you have spent 2 hours for reading one chapter. After 24 hours, it will take not more than 15 minutes. After 7 days, it will not take more than 5 or 10 minutes. And after 1 month, it will not take more than 5 minutes. So in this way, 5 minutes you can spare. In this way, you can retain your memory, whether you are preparing for your examination or whether you are preparing for some competitive examinations. So you being, that's the smart one. Hard worker is doing the hard work, he is reading the things, but during the examination time, everything is lost. So it's not, it says hard work is not paying you. So be smart, do according to that, do according to what your scientific memory would be, so that you can retain the things well. And as a result, you need not to have spent a large amount of time on that again. So the memory works like that. So next is, remove the negativity and think positive. So what do you mean by remove the negativity? Mukesh? So whenever, suppose the fear, negativity comes because of the fear. You have the fear. That is, what can I do? Suppose I have completed my M.Tech and I am not getting the job after M.Tech. What can I do? I can sit at home. I don't want to sit at home. What the people will say? What our relatives will say? Kyunki ghar se zyada fikr to rishtedaron ko hoti hai. Theek hai? So what they will say? Don't get carried away by these kind of thoughts. Believe in yourself. Whenever you are getting out of the bed, you should say something to you, some lines, that this day is the best day of my life. I am the best in my work. I have to do best. I have to do best, and I will be in a good position after this by working hard. So whenever you are, sometimes it happens to everyone, whosoever it would be, because the desires never die. We are the human beings. Even Ambani, he is a billionaire, but still maybe sometimes when he is getting out of his bed and he feels that my company should be number one. So that is his level of desire. But other people has different levels of desire. Sometimes you are getting out of the bed and feel very negative in that respect. So don't be carried away by negative thoughts. Be positive, get energetic, and write some lines of famous authors or motivational speakers on your wherever you sleep, so that you should have a look on that, and you will see that this I have to do, because hard work pays you. If you are working hard, if I doing well, then at one point of time you are getting what you are desiring. You will face the failures if you see the maximum of people that are like the most successful people in the world. They have faced failures in life, but finally they struggled with life, they fight with the life, and finally get out of that and begin good entrepreneurs or businessmen. Have you heard the story of Elon Musk? Elon Musk, he is now entering the field of rocket making. He is the first man whose company has made the rocket such that it will come to Earth back. Even his two or three experiments failed, but finally he has money for only one experiment, but still he carried that experiment, and finally his company is going to be one of the best companies in this space business. So his story is very inspiring, how at the age of 15 or 16 he has some website, he sold it to some company, made his company like that, he keep on selling and he don't have money initially. So follow his life. Follow the life of great people like we have the APJ Abdul Kalam. How from a very small village he grows to that level that he became that person. So that will give you the positivity. That will also give you the work ethics. That what work ethics you follow, because you are going to be the future leaders. So you should have that thing. See good movies so that you can get motivated. Read some novels, like you have Wings of Fire by Abdul Kalam. Then we have one more is Three Are There by Abdul Kalam. Ignited Minds and Rings of Fire, and one more is there.
Vision
2020. So you can see, you can read that so that you can get ignited in this way. Negativity is also because of the negative people around you. So because some people are there, so nothing will happen, nothing is going to happen, this and this. I am giving so many papers, but everything, corruption is there, this is there. So try to make it possible that your friend who is a negative, try to make it positive. But if it is not positive, then you can be away from him. Because negativity is because of that environment in which you are there. So be positive and follow the great leaders, or follow the great people who are small during the initial stage, but after that they achieved so much. Okay. Next is eat healthy and stay healthy. So the mind of any person depends on the body. So you should daily, your routine should be that you should start at 6, go for a walk, have some yoga, perform yoga, and eat healthy. Don't go for junk food and cold drink like kind of thing. Always eat healthy and have salad in your food, because if your body is healthy, then your mind will be healthy. कितने बजे उठते हो तुम लोग सुबह?
5 बजे.
चलो ठीक है, लेकिन एक because you get the environment here, that you are having this ground also, so you should develop the habit. For a few days you will have some problem. After that your life will be smooth once you feel that you are whatever you suppose you want to reduce your weight. Kimankur. So you should start. Like one inspiration person is there, Karan sir. He was very heavy nearly 6 to 7 months back, He was even weight was more than 110, like that. But now you will see him, he's very slim. And the day in, he used to take 3 or 4 rounds of the ground, and then he worked on this, that food also. Now he's very slim. Otherwise, in during 6 months back, 7 months back, he was very fat. You can. He's also a source of some person has this inspiration that I can be, that is my weight will reduce some extent. He can. So that is also a kind of inspiration. So be healthy. Try to be healthy whenever whatever is available. Don't eat anything like that. Avoid junk food, fast food, whatever the healthy food is available. You can go for it. Next is the selfless work. So selfless work means that you are not in your life, you are not here to do only your work. You can get associated with something, like in 1984 you have one NGO is there, Priyas. They are doing a very nice work. At least spend some time, not more than half an hour. But the little children would be there and teach them small things like this mathematics and small things. You will feel very happy when you are working for them. You will have a kind of satisfaction also. So get attached with someone, or get if someone needs help. Suppose BTech student is there, he needs help. So provide him some help so that it can be good for you. It will satisfy your mind also. So get associated with some social work, so that you can be, mind can be ignited, so that you can get the inspiration also that I am. At least whatever, because you are getting, we people also used to get 5,000 MHRD, you are getting 12,000, so it's all the taxpayers' money. So at least if you are doing very well, I'm not talking in a very rude manner, but we also used to take during our time, it was 5,000, but it's the taxpayers' money. So if we are giving it in some way back, learning about some social issues that is facing near about that and thinking about that and finding some solution. Here the culture is different. When I was in Gujarat, one social engineering class was there, social engineering lab on Saturday. Saturday was working there. So in the social engineering we have to go to nearby villages. And the students can prepare the report depending on that what's the problems are and what's their probable solution. They had to interact with the people there, and after interacting they will find out some solutions. Suppose some sanitation problem is there or some school problem is there. So they do the social engineering, they prepared a plan of that, and after 3 or 4 months they used to prepare, they used to get the presentation on that. And then they provide that facilities to their nearby villages so that the life can be improved. So, be since you are in NIT, so be associated with some Priyas kind of thing, or be have some give some suggestions also if you want to the authorities also, then it should be like that. Now, next is share your knowledge. It is very important point, because in the coaching institutes and all that, the sharing of the knowledge is very limited, maybe limited 1 or 2 people, because they are the competitors. So once you are sharing your knowledge, your level of knowledge will increase. Suppose we are teaching something, so we have one concept and we are teaching something, and suppose 100 students will be there. Someone asks a question in some other way, so we can think in some other way. So that's the beauty of sharing the knowledge. Money you cannot give to anyone, money is your own, but knowledge is such a thing that once you share with anyone, it can increase. Your understanding will increase. You will see, like you have seen that some teachers are teaching without any paper like that. So it means that their level of knowledge has increased, by constantly practice that kind of meditation. So you can share, if anyone wants help in your class, you can share the knowledge, you can try to work accordingly. And the last point is that the law of karma, one law of karma is there, that suppose you are living in one environment, suppose you are living in some environment, whatever your actions of that environment, it depends upon the environment, it depends upon people there. It means that you are unconsciously doing that. Suppose you are sitting in some atmosphere, atmosphere is there, and in that atmosphere some people are there who are negative, their thoughts are negative, and in that atmosphere suppose you will react, you will also react negatively in that. You will also react negatively because your atmosphere is like that, but you are doing unconsciously. You don't know. Law of karma is that you can change your way of thinking. What you can do, instead of be in that environment, try to change the environment or try to get out of that environment, that is done consciously. Because unconsciously you won't able to understand. But when your conscious arises, you will see that because of this company, so many people, every negativity is there. What am I doing? Try to change their viewpoint, because we are doing it, you are doing it with conscious mind. And try to change the environment also, so that consciously you can strive towards success. Okay? So this is the law of the karma that you can do with the conscious mind. Whatever is there unconsciously, you can do it with your conscious by changing the environment. Life is always full of problems, obstacles, sometimes good times or bad times. Don't take it otherwise that meri kismat hi kharab hai ya kuch nahi hota या कोई जहन नहीं निकल रहा. डोंट टेक इट लाइक दैट. गेट द नेगेटिव्स आउट ऑफ दैट एंड आफ्टर गेटिंग द नेगेटिव्स वंस यू विल गेट व्हाटएवर यू वांट. मैक्सिमम ऑफ द पीपल हु आर इन वेरी सक्सेसफुल दे आर हैविंग अ वेरी अनसक्सेसफुल आर वेरी डिफरेंट पास्ट. दोज हु आर सक्सेसफुल ऑलवेज सक्सेसफुल then their past is not so it's like that. It may be smooth. So they have not seen any problems in life. But those people who are very successful nowadays, look at their past, you can see that whatever they have faced, it's very difficult to face as a common man. So get inspired by these kind of people, read the biographies, people, try to read the good novel, neglect the people who are negative, keep the thought always positive and eat healthy and be healthy, do yoga every day so that your life can be. Because whatever you have nowadays, you have taken so much money from parents. So it's your responsibility to give them back in some respect. Because they are spending the hard-earned money on you. So it's your responsibility to give them back in some way or other. So it's the time to work hard and do whatever you want. ठीक है? That is all. So that is a simple. क्या time हो गया?